So first of all, of course, this 60th anniversary of the Treaty of Rome, it's a kind of reflection for all of us where this European Union, which is a unique project on the planet, brought prosperity and peace to the EU citizens. And of course, enlargement, I think, is one of the best achievements for European project. But of course, we are at the forefront to witness a lot of challenges like migration, fragile economic development, and also a lot of nationalistic and anti-European views. So I think it's very important to put on the table all the options, not to, the Commission didn't want to be arrogant and say this is a way to follow, because we are aware there are many criticism, at the same time, of course, many expectations. But it's obvious that Europe cannot make miracles without member states doing their jobs. So I think now it's very important, of course, to start this debate where we want to go, what kind of Europe we need. But in the same time, of course, we have to have proofs, because, for instance, in my European Cohesion, I am fighting for it. It's not a secret that it's very much under attack because there are a lot of money. But in the same time, I want to underline the unique feature of this policy, that we are dealing with 300 regions and we have policies tailor-made for each regions, and many of these regions are now where they are because of cohesion policy. For instance, in Germany, which is a rich country, we have created more than 100,000 jobs, and for the first time in the last 7 years, the Eastern European lands are not less developed regions, but regions in transition, which means regions with the GDP per capita between 75% and 90% of the average. The only policy which has these direct links with national, regional presidents, with the mayors. So if we don't have this policy, which has direct link with citizens, I don't know how European Union could be closer to the citizens. So for me and from my point of view, I think this cohesion policy is more needed than ever, despite of all necessities that we have and all the pressures that we have, because it's obvious that Brexit and other, new priorities like security, internal, external, and all the discussion about European army will put some pressure on the European budget. But in the same time, we have to preserve what is in the benefit of the citizens, and this cohesion policy could be seen everywhere, in every corner of European Union, directly from the better transport, better hospitals, better schools, roads. So I think it's very important to preserve it. First of all, I would like to congratulate you for everything you are doing. I think the role of the media is first and foremost to inform correctly. I started my career as a journalist, and I can confess you that at that time we had our political convictions, of course, but we were not so politicized like today. So now I think it's very important to be honest with ourselves and not to try to impose as journalists our point of view. I'm at the middle of my mandate, and I can tell you stories. And I think I did a lot, and I worked a lot, and we did a lot in the European Commission in these 2.5 years in order to be much more closer to the citizens, and not always this work was reflected by the media. So it's not a reproach, how to say, it's not something to put into question, but it's a moment of responsibility for everybody. So as I said in the beginning, if we put all the guilty on the European Commission or European Union, we are wrong, because we have all our responsibilities of our level. European Union, member states, national governments, national parliaments, public authorities and also media.